this basement area, what we stood in at the moment, it was full of soil to the actual underside of the ceiling joist. It was completely full of rubble infill, what they used when they built the Abbey hundreds of years ago, but all the surplus material was chucked down this area. The room next door was a storage area, like a pantry area come food storage. I say this room was completely full, no one knew it existed, they thought it was just a void. Access to the property was a very big challenge indeed. Getting the materials out, another big challenge. We had to use a conveyor belt through a little 600 square hole at the end of the building. And everything by wheelbarrow, there's no way you could get a machine in, it's all physical. We had to underpin the walls because they were structurally unsound. Bear in mind, they're carrying three stories above us where we're standing. This is the main foundation of the building. We've gone below the foundation line with actual concrete. There's 86 pads a metre square of concrete underneath these walls, supporting these walls. All this ground was dug out, and then this floor is a new lime creek floor in this area, and there's six boilers going to be down this area for the main heating situation on the actual abbey itself. Being it's an enclosed room, there's no natural ventilation. We've got to put underground ventilation pipes at 300 square pipes to give air intake and air outlets for the boilers. Bear in mind there's six gas boilers, and the air intake is quite tremendous on these boilers. And there's no windows, there's no doors, everything's got to come in and go out by artificial means. This is the hub of the building, basically. The general public will not see this, which is a shame because there's a lot of workers in this area.